Welcome, graduates of the class of 2020. Welcome, proud parents and family members. Welcome, faculty and all the members of the ZIS community. Today, we come together to celebrate the achievements of the 129 members of the ZIS class of 2020 and to send them off into the world with wind in their sails. Graduates, as I envision the world you will live in and lead, the tasks before you seem daunting. J.F. Richard, the first European vice president for the World Bank between 1998 and 2005, wrote a book entitled High Noon, 20 Global Problems and 20 Years to Solve Them. In this prescient manifesto, he explored 20 significant challenges which are creating unprecedented stressors due to the world demographic explosion and the new world economy. He described challenges such as deforestation and water scarcity, global taxation and biodiversity, and globally infectious diseases such as the one that is preventing us today from coming together to celebrate you. As he pondered these problems, he made it clear that they could be alleviated by what he described as global issues networks. That is, by multilateral transdisciplinary teams eager to collaborate effectively with others from around the world to solve shared global problems. This would, of course, require teams with deep expertise in specific disciplines and broad understanding across disciplines. It saddens me to share with you the fact that J.F. Richard published this book in 2002, the year most of you were born. During the intervening time, the adults in charge have not heeded his call. In fact, things are much worse today than they were during the year in which you were born. That means that much of the fixing and the global alliances required to do this work will fall to you to create. But as I imagine those best prepared to address these issues, I need look no further than the ZIS class of 2020. You have all learned to work well on multinational teams, and you've developed the depth of knowledge required for you to complete successfully the ZIS diploma, meaning that you've taken a number of advanced placement courses or IB higher level courses. During your time at ZIS, you have all developed the habits of heart and the habits of mind necessary to solve collaboratively the kinds of problems we are facing today and that you will continue to face into the future. Class of 2020, we send you off today with great pride and also much anticipation. May you find worthy challenges to address, and may you make this world a better place. We will now hear from Pauline Beeck, our alumni speaker from the class of 2011.
Hello and congratulations to the class of 2020. I've been asked to share a few words with you today. This time 9 years ago seemed like the pinnacle of my life. My grades seemed like my life's most momentous achievement, and in many ways at the time it was. But today things are slightly different. Under these strange circumstances, for many of you, the exams won't have taken place. And I can tell you that my 18-year-old self would have been absolutely devastated if mine had been cancelled. I was very stuck to my plan to study super hard, to get the best grades, to do international relations at university, and then to solve climate change by working at the UN. And that's not quite how it panned out. But it did all start here at ZIS in the 7th grade, when we watched Al Gore's An Inconvenient Truth, and I was absolutely petrified by the prospect of climate change. So at that point, I decided that any academic or career moves I made would be geared towards saving the planet. I had a very structured plan, which in many ways didn't pan out. I ended up going to my third choice university, which I loved. I did lots of NGO internships to prepare me for the UN, which I really didn't like. Then I did a fantastic master's at the LSE in environmental policy. And now I work as a client manager at an environmental consultancy helping the fashion sector decarbonize. It took me 30 job rejections to get this one, but it's here that I've been recognized by Forbes for this year's 30 under 30 in the retail and e-commerce category. Not because I started my own company, but because I've driven impact in fashion sustainability through the company that I work for. So there's two things I would really love to impart on you today, and they're quite linked. Firstly, COVID-19 has shown us how quickly we have to adapt. In many ways, you're fortunate that this early in your adult life, you've learned that when things veer drastically from plan, which they will, you can adapt and you can make the most out of anything. I certainly would have benefited from learning this a little earlier on in life. But what I have learned is that so long as we remain open to life, great opportunities we could never have actually planned for really do come our way. And secondly, times are changing. Many have linked this crisis to the human impact on the environment. But nature has bounced back, and many cities are putting in place policies to keep the air as clean as it was during the lockdown period. It's clear that the world will not be the same after this, and the topic of sustainability has never been more important. And the signs from society have never been more encouraging. In fact, many industries may not recover to what they were before this crisis, because it's shown that they are truly unsustainable. We really are redesigning our future, so let's hope it's a green one. So as you decide on your passions and dreams, think hard about how these fit into the world of the future and not the world of the past. Despite everything that's going on, it's still a really exciting time to make life choices. The economy is full of disruptive technology, new services, and an abundance of opportunities to make your mark and drive change, as I have. So take your time figuring out how you want to fit into this new world, and be open to anything.
Good morning and welcome to ZIS's first virtual graduation ceremony for the class of 2020.
For those of you who don't know, my name is Nicholas Lustenberger.
And I'm Isabelle Dady.
And we will be your graduation speakers. We were surprised as you that the grade voted two econ students to write the speech. But don't worry, we're going to try our best to get through this without the use of line graphs.
We are currently living in an extraordinary situation that 4 months ago none of us could have ever envisioned. I mean, who thought we'd all be here today graduating online?
But regardless whether we celebrate online or in person, we've all gathered here today as a community to witness this unforgettable milestone in our young adult lives. And that's what really matters.
Let's not let this untraditional graduation stop us from enjoying our final moments as a class together.
Unlike many other grades, our grade thrived off of our individuality, our uniqueness, and the small things that set us apart and make us different from each other. And though this may not be your typical expectation of an ideal grade, we're not typical at all. In fact, we're very special. Our unusual senior year can definitely vouch for that.
But first, let's take a few steps back from senior year and take a look at the rest of our high school experience. Remember all the way back in 9th and 10th grade? You know, the time when we actually went to advisory and we spent countless days doing all these bonding exercises, running through the streets of Zurich, making chocolate at the Lindt chocolate factory, dragon boating, and much more. At the time, it all seemed pointless. We were finally in high school and we wanted our independence. It wasn't cool to like your advisory.
But the other day, Isabel and I were looking through some of these advisory photos, and it made us appreciate the time that we got to spend together as a whole grade, you know, before the IP versus AB war began. And it definitely made us appreciate being within 2 meters of each other.
And how could we forget Romania, the only trip we all shared in high school?
Wait, weren't we all split in separate groups though?
Nick, that's not the point. Regardless of whether we were separated or not, we did all share that fear of being on the sketchy chartered plane together.
Right, and the 5 whole days at that construction site really helped us all grow so much as people, am I right?
Definitely. And then there's 10th grade, the last year you could make a presentation about your personal growth in English as a final exam.
I can vividly remember 1 week in 10th grade. You know, you'd walk down the hallways and everywhere you'd look, there'd just be a different scene from Macbeth being performed. Something like, I defy you stars.
Firstly, that's from Romeo and Juliet. And secondly, that was in 9th grade.
Oh, my bad. I guess I really don't remember Macbeth or 10th grade as well as I thought.
And then 11th grade came, and we were forced to search deep into our souls and ask ourselves the difficult question.
Cal for Vior.
I was talking about AP or IB.
Oh, still two very difficult decisions.
In all seriousness, 11th grade was when we all went on our separate academic pathways and focused on our individual growth. But at the same time, we all realized we were in the final stage of high school, and this made our personal connections with one another grow even stronger.
The workload and intensity started to crank up a lot, and it didn't matter if you were AP or IB, because we all found something we have in common. We love complaining about school. And in a strange way, that sort of brought us all closer together. You gotta remember all those cram sessions out at the Zeppe library, or those unexpected bonding during our different free blocks. And of course, we were finally allowed to go to the smoking benches.
But don't worry, most of us don't go there to smoke. We go there to enjoy the view and gossip with Miss Fritzen.
Right, right. And then with a blink of an eye, our senior year arrived. You know, when they say that the first semester of 12th grade is the hardest part of high school, they're not joking.
Everything seemed to be happening all at once. We were trying to finish our final year of high school strong while simultaneously planning our futures after high school. Whether it be applying to university, planning a gap year, or preparing to serve your country, the stress united us.
And the stress paid off. When the time came that university started to release the decisions, you could almost feel the anxiety lingering in the air. But you could also feel the support, the companionship, and the excitement shared amongst your fellow seniors. Everyone was rooting for you guys.
Before then, we were quite independent as a grade. There wasn't a strong connection that everyone shared. But during this time when everyone was building their futures, we've never been so close to one another.
Everyone was so interested and supportive of each other's plans after high school. It didn't matter where you were going or what you were doing, because for the first time in many of your lives, you were in control of your future. You were able to decide how you wanted to leave your mark in this world. That's when the sense of support and encouragement kicked in, because everyone around you knew that you were pursuing something that you truly wanted to do with your lives.
This sensation is really hard to put into words, but class of 2020, we know you know the feeling we're talking about.
Unfortunately, this feeling was cut a little short when the coronavirus came knocking on our door. We didn't get the end of our senior year that we had expected or dreamt of, but that just continues to show how special of a grade ours is.
Our senior year was also supposed to be a significant point for our parents. After raising us for 18 years, their blood, sweat, and tears was this close to finally paying off as we left home and entered the real world.
But now they're stuck with us for a few extra months. I'm sure they didn't expect to babysit us 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. But regardless, they continue to support us, whether it be suppressing exam nerves, reassuring our uncertainties, or just simply making us dinner every night. They went above and beyond.
So this ceremony is also a celebration of our parents. I know we all wanted to be here together today. Go on our CWWs, go on our grad trips, and go to prom. All events that would have united us as a grade so much more. But hey, they say trauma is the best way to bring people together. So shout out to COVID.
But just remember that when we do all reconnect, it will be better than we could have ever imagined.
We aren't going to take the time we spend together for granted anymore, because we now truly understand how important it is to be and see with one another.
Coming out of this extraordinary situation, we emerged stronger than before, better equipped than before, and ready to take on this world. We stood tall in the face of these difficult times and adapted to the best of our abilities. The APs finished off all their exams, the IBs are still going to get their diplomas, and we're all still here, graduating from high school. The next pandemic we'll have to think twice before messing with our class of 2020.
We have faith that every single one of you will use your rigor, resourcefulness, and resilience to drive you to success in all aspects of your life. Congratulations, everyone, once again. We can't wait to see you all in person and celebrate together. Here's to the class of 2020. We did it.